Yeah.
If I can't do it, homie, it can't be done. Now I'ma let the champagne bottle pop.
What's up, everybody? It's Gas Money. And again, I have a short 20-minute clip of a coaching call that I did, and I want to share it with you guys because I think it's powerful. One of the reasons why you might struggle, why a lot of people struggle, is because you're too in your head. You second guess everything. You'll ask God for a sign and you'll second guess the sign. You won't know what direction you need to go in life, and you'll just listen to somebody in a position of authority in the world when in all reality it never resonated with you at the core. I'm talking about alignment. I'm talking about listening. I'm talking about listening with to above. That's all of our job. A great leader is a great listener. We have to practice at getting in alignment every single day and becoming so attuned to what God is instructing us to do in our lives. And that's what I want you to get good at. So this coaching call touches on that, and I want you to watch it all the way from beginning to end. Listen to it while you're driving. Listen to it while you work out. Listen to it while you're doing dishes, however you want to do it. But make sure you're catching the gems. Open up your heart and receive. Like, receive what I'm saying. Open up your mind to it. Make sure you like this video if you rock with it. Make sure you comment to let me know what you got from the call. And then make sure you subscribe. I'll see you. Enjoy the video. Let's go. Like, they don't teach us how to listen. Like in music, like when I learned how to play music, I learned by listening, by observing and trusting. A lot of you are waiting for a motherfucker to be like, yeah, that's good. That's cool. Run that. And it's just totally wrong. It'll get you by. It'll probably make you some money. But like, you have no rest. You have anxiety in there. And that's what I want to like push you and urge you towards, is to learn how to practice at like expanding your capacity to listen, to trust yourself more. Does that make sense to anybody? Does that like really, like, do you feel what I'm saying? Because you're waiting for a motherfucker to tell you that it's right when you know in your heart that it was right years ago. Can I get something in the chat? I literally wish you guys were in person, because then I could like feel your energy. But like, I can't have the mics on and everything. But tell me if that's true or not. And for those who are new, I want you to understand something, please. Those of you who came to me and you're wanting to change your life, you want to get fit, you want to just level up in life, but you don't know, you don't even know what this is about. I want you to trust me and follow this. I'm leading you. I'm building your foundation for you. You just have to follow my lead. I was telling Rudy and just everybody who was here, I was like, if you go to, think about how boring going to the gym, going to your job. Think about just lifting. Okay, you lift it down, you push it back up, and back down, and then back up. And then you're gonna do this thousands of times. If you don't make that metaphorical connection with something greater, something, a universal connection, a connection to God, a purpose, that is absolutely insane. You're just doing the same things over and over with no deeper connection, no deeper meaning. How I'm trying to connect that dot for you is that everything that you do should have meaning. You should connect everything. Let me tell you guys why the first step in your transition in leveling up, your first transition into your new identity, your first transition of how you know that you're meant for more, you want to know what it is? Is that you feel like you don't fit in. It's very hard to have conversations. You feel like you're outcasted from your family. You feel different. You don't feel like you fit in. Does anybody in this room, put it in the chat, like literally put it in, I need to know. That is a sign that you know that you're awakening. That's your sign right there. Am I speaking to anybody? I swear, I wish mics, like I wish we could have the mics on, because I know that I'm talking to some people right here. But this is what happens, is that you feel that and you think something's wrong with you. You feel that and like, you don't trust it. 100% at the beginning of my new life. I felt that from the beginning of my life. It took a while for me to like have the courage and the personal development to really just sit in it. V, what you got on that?
Yeah, I mean, I think the sign that everyone who is here, you're a leader, like, and when you lead people, you're going to be the first in a lot of your groups, in like your family and your friend groups, whatever. And you're going to have to set yourself apart and act different than everybody else in order to lead people out of that. But you got to lead yourself first.
Absolutely. I want you guys to really hear me and let this sit in. You're not meant to fit in. Leaders do not fit in. Leadership is a lonely road, but guess what? We have this group. You know how powerful this group is? I only hang out with my clients. Those are the only people that you're going to see me hanging out with. I can't hang out with anybody else. I left Rudy's house and I was like, hey, you know, like, what do you, I can't remember what the last thing I said, but I was like, who else are you going to hang out with? Like, who else you got? You can't hang out with the people you drink with. You can't hang out with, you know, these other people that don't share the same core values in growth, in money, in business, in God, and all that type of stuff. So this is why this community is, you need a community. You need that. Absolutely. But like overall, it's lonely. And that's okay. That's all right. Because you're never lonely. I just really want you guys to get more spiritual as much as possible. Because look, you believe you have a spirit, right? You believe you have a soul, right? You guys have all said these things. you have all said things like that. If you say things like that and you say like universal stuff, you're spiritual. You're just not fully tapping into it because you're not sure. You're nervous about it. And all I'm trying to say is open the next door, really delve into it, because everything becomes spiritual. If you lack money, you lack spirituality. Like there's a portion of you that lacks spirituality. It lacks trust. It lacks faith. Does that make sense to anybody? Like I'm showing you a door, and it's up to you to start walking into it. Because I can keep talking and talking and talking. You're going to have to do action and like walk in some of those doors. Yeah. Are they hearing me, V? Are we getting through today?
I think they're on board. We're still warming up a little bit. We're a little rusty. I feel it.
I feel like we are, huh?
Yeah.
A little bit. Yeah. Yeah. Here's the real point that I really want to tell you. You have two identities. You guys know that? You have two identities. You have one when you're born, and then one when you find out your real assignment, gifted from above. That's your real identity. All of the stories in the Bible, like people who did great things, they had a second name. Even God like had a second name, 3, 4, 5 names. Like, so most people, they live off of that little negative nickname from like 9 years old, or they still see themselves as that old identity. And when we go back to, you know, leveling up, making more money, improving your life, you're never going to outperform your identity. I'm telling you, like, your vision, your identity, your purpose, that is like paramount. Those are big ones. Those aren't small ones. Because I've had people like ask me, like, why do you talk about that so much? I'm like, what else is there to talk about? It's like the funnest thing to talk about. Are you living out your ambition, or are you living out your new identity's ambition? Meaning, AKA God's ambition for your life. That's how you know, like, there's a difference between living comfortably and living restfully. There's a difference between, I don't know if you guys caught that. There's a difference between living comfortably and then living in rest, living in alignment. Do you guys hear me? You guys get that? Put in the chat, like, I'm genuinely wanting to know, like, your honest feedback of what you get from that, because a lot of you are chasing your ambitions. You're trying to chase the bag, trying to get the money, trying to chase the result. I'm like, anything you chase is running from you. Anything that you're trying to like chase, I know it's not, you don't have rest and peace inside. Am I speaking to anybody? It's crazy. Yeah, it's crazy, man. B, what you got right there?
Man, it's so good because, like, what I think, like, it makes me think about the times when I've been anxious about something, and like I've run after it and tried to get it, and you know, like, you're just like striving so hard versus the times when I'm just trusting God and believing in faith. I still do things, but like, there's a rest in that. Like, just because you're like in action doesn't mean you're not at rest. It's more of a soul thing.
Like, not like kicking your feet up is not rest. Rest means that you are void of anxiety. Rest means that you're void of like doubt and worry. Why is it that you can just be lying in your bed and you know you should get up? You know you got to get up, and you start having that anxiety, like, I know I need to do something. I know I got to get, I don't know what it is. There's a lot of layers that are blocking that for you. You know you got to get up, but you don't know what you need to do. I hope you're picking up what I'm putting down. That's lack of vision. That's lack of discipline. It's a lack of connection. And these are, I'm not trying to like, over, I hope I'm not overwhelming any of you. What I'm trying to say is this. That's your program right there. It's a removal process. We're not here to add anything. Like, a lot of you guys have to-do lists. Oh, I have my to-do list. Yeah, I write all day. I have all these to-do lists. I'm like, motherfucker, you shouldn't have a to-do list. You should have a not to-do list, and then you should have a list of removal. What do you need to remove? Because all those answers, all those downloads that we all need, they're there. They're there. We all have the answers right there. But what's blocking those answers is what we have to get to. We have to be masters at the removal process. Does that make sense to everybody? I hope that does. So, like, two identities. I want you to realize, like, your first identity is not the real you. Your second identity is the real you. That's when you start walking into your purpose. Your purpose is hidden in your trauma. You've heard me say that, been saying that for years. Your purpose is found in hard times. Your purpose is found in the dark. Man, I hope I'm not like jacking you guys up with talking about all these like deeper concepts. I really do. I honestly question, that's why I'm gonna bring it back to like basic ass shit, like, wake the fuck up in the morning, hit your fucking macros, because I don't want a bunch of elevated people who know all this shit but look like shit, who don't have money, who don't, you like, you need, I just want to pressure you that you have to have both. Because you'll reach a point where you can't go any further spiritually in this side that I'm taking you towards, if you don't have that foundation of like, hey, make sure you get up, you stick on your wake-ups. Make sure you hit the gym. I because that's what I think that you guys, I'm here to remind you this. You struggle, man, a lot of women struggle with this. A lot of, and I'll just say it plainly, a lot of women struggle for this exact reason. Lack of structure, lack of discipline, and emotional regulation is up and down like this. Women are just naturally, notoriously like that. So any of the women on the program, it's paramount that you have structure, that you see life as low frequency and high frequency. It's not a diss. It got guys feel it too. It's just that women feel it like harder, so much more. Like anybody who's had hormone issues, like with their body, it's the worst. Like I've had it, it's hard. So like your program has is paramount. And so what I'm saying is that there's a battle between your flesh and your spirit all the time. They're tussling, they're wrestling together. Do you guys feel me? And where you get lost and you're like, man, like I don't feel motivated. I'm like, I know why you don't feel motivated. You've been feeding your flesh. You've been feeding your body. You've been feeding comfort and not your spirit. And that's where that motivation is. And that's why you come to this watering hole and you just like get replenished again. And I'm like, I light your ass up and be like, no, motherfucker, like get that shit back going and you're good for the next 6, 7 days. That's the power of like this community and these calls. Because I was telling Rudy, I'm like, people don't realize like how much power and strength God flows through these calls. Because I'm like, let me pull the calls back for 3 weeks in a row. Seriously, not everybody comes to the calls. I know that. But for you guys here, let me pull the calls back for don't listen to the recordings. Don't listen to anything. Watch how bad and hard your life is. It's fucking rough. And God's voice starts closing up. I'm not saying it's impossible. I'm saying most likely God's voice closes up, your motivation goes down, your everything just gets worse. So I want you guys to double down on this, take notes, and then just go apply in your life. Like all you really need is like I said so many things already. If you just took like one or two of those things and just really ran with it, it would be beautiful. I want you to understand though, how you know you're out of alignment, how you know you're off of your assignment is when you feel anxiety, when you don't feel good. When you're on purpose, you want to work. You will want to work. Like I could do this all day, guys, in a variation like talking, working, writing, praying. I could do this all day. This is not a business like move. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is not a business. Like, I don't think anything should be like that, to be honest. You should just be like tapped into your new identity. Like, before you ever knew before you ever knew your purpose, guess who knew your purpose? God knew your purpose before you ever knew your purpose. So, what is your job? What are you doing to tap into that? You have to find out what your assignment is, what you need to do, what you're here. So the question is like this. People struggle because they're like, what is life going to offer me? What can I get out of life? And the question should be this. What am I here to fulfill? That's what you should be asking yourself. Every morning, I'm like, what does the world like need from me? What do I need to fulfill? What is my role and my job? Now you're an offering. Now you're of service. Now you're of value. That's why some of you are like not really digging like what you do anymore. It's because you outgrew it. You outgrew your profession. Because that wasn't your assignment. That was your profession. There's a difference. All I'm trying to push you guys to is be authentic, be real, like really listen. I want you guys to be better listeners. And because you'll never have to take a day off in your life. You'll never have to take a vacation ever in your life because you're just doing, you're being, you're not doing. A lot of people are doing, and we're supposed to just be. V, am I making sense?
100%.
What are your thoughts?
I mean, makes me think about what you said towards the beginning when you were like, you have two identities, the day, the one you were born with and the one you figure out what your purpose is. And it's like you unless you learn what that is and you tap into that, like nothing is going to fill that void. Like that is a call on, I think, all of our hearts that like is longing to be satisfied.
I couldn't agree more. That's why I'm pushing so hard on like guys, like not figure out, but remove everything, like create those not to-do lists. Remove, because we're trying to walk into that new identity.
Yep. Three, nine, eight, one. Come on.